9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, are you ready?
Church, y'all ready to worship today? Y'all want to hear some more music from our new album? Y'all want to hear some more music? How are we going to do a new song for you? But y'all know the song. Just see what I need y'all to do. Clap your hands. Let's go. We're remix worship, so we just remix something. That's all right? Goes like this.
fire. In your presence, I consume a bold desire. Holy Spirit, bring the flame of the fire. As I unleash my worship amongst the choir, I'm your temple, I wanna be overcome. You fit well like a hand in the glove. You my consuming fire, you're my God of love. Descend upon me like a dove from above.
Holy Spirit, you my comfort apart, yet of the Trinity. Jesus said to come and you dwell, know your divinity. Holy Spirit, pray in my heart, spoken in tongue. Giving reverence to you, my Lord, fallen Son. We welcome you. I know that you got us in all truth. Giving us all the power to overcome in our view. To other day I choose to follow you in obedience. Holy Spirit, you move. The Spirit of the first Lord.
Are you guys excited to be at church today? Hallelujah. Come on, let's worship.
Is anybody waiting on God to do something in their lives? Let me ask somebody over here. Is anybody really waiting on God to do something for you? This song, we just want to say that you got to wait on the Lord. Amen.
I don't believe in fairy tales. I guess I've outgrown them. But that doesn't mean that I don't believe that there's something bigger than me. 'Cause I've seen it in a hospital room when the doctor said sorry. There's nothing more we can do. Ooh, well, it wasn't through. I've never seen a pot of gold at the end of a rainbow, but I've got a promise I can hold in the middle of a struggle. God, if you said it, you'll perform it. May not be how I want you to, but here's what I'll do.
Y'all sing.
I'm gonna wait on you.
I'm gonna wait on you. I've tasted your goodness. I've trusted your promise. I'm gonna wait on you. I'm gonna wait on you. I've tasted your goodness. I've trusted your promise.
Wait on the Lord.
never leave us. You never forsake us. Even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we will fear no evil because you are with us and you lead us and you guide us. You're a man of your word and you haven't failed. You're the same God of yesterday, of today, and you'll be that same God tomorrow. So God, we're going to wait on your promises. We're going to wait on your promises.
What y'all say?
Sing it. That's what happens when you wait.
I feel God moving in here already. Can we sing that again? Sing that.
They that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up, up on wings like an eagle and soar. They shall walk. They shall run and not dare. That's what happens when you wait.
Let's sing that again.
They that wait on the Lord.
They that wait.
Shall renew.
On the Lord.
Shall renew.
Shall renew.
Their strength.
Their strength.
They shall mount up.
They shall mount up.
Up on wings.
Up on wings.
Like an eagle.
Like an eagle.
And soar. They shall walk and not get weary. They shall run.
That's what happens when you wait.
That's what happens when you wait. They that wait on the Lord.
They that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up, up on wings like an eagle's and soar. They shall walk, not be weary. They shall run.
Thank you.
encourage you this morning. The words of that song are so, so powerful. And I don't want you to miss such a key element is waiting on the Lord, because it's hard in those seasons of waiting, those seasons when you're expecting and asking and pleading and kneeling before God for a miracle, and you're just waiting. And it's in that season that He's going to continue to renew you. But you have to have a childlike faith to expect things that you've never seen, anticipate things that you don't understand. Because the waiting room, oh, the waiting room builds such perseverance. Father, we're so grateful. We're so grateful that your truth is true to our heartbeat. We're so grateful that your power and that your direction and that your guidance and that your ways are so much better than ours. And yet sometimes we grow tired in the waiting room. I pray that we would have hearts that are leaning into your timing, minds that are accepting of your will, feet that will wait to be told when to move and when to stand. Oh God, we ask today that you would continue to strengthen us, to give us direction, to give us patience when we need it, and allow us to continue to worship you in the storm, worship you in the waiting room, worship you as we believe and pray and anticipate for miracles. God, there are things in our lives that we may be facing this week or facing today that we don't understand. I pray that we would trust your ways, oh God. For you are faithful and you are good. You are good, period. You are faithful, period. You know all things, period. We trust in you for everything, oh God. So today, as we continue to worship you, God, allow us to have eyes to look to you, hearts to be open, ears to be ready to receive your word and your truth. Because we know that without you, we are nothing. And with you, we have everything that we need. It's in your precious name we say, amen. Listen, as you continue to worship, this is a time that you can give. I'm not gonna go through it all. The text, the information is on the screen. Allow your hearts to give at this time as we worship with our giving and with our mouths.
Can I be honest for a moment? Is that all right? Can I be honest for a moment? As we're standing here in his presence. About a week and a half ago, I had to be quarantined. And it was right in the midst of a time where I was being very productive. I was being very productive. We had this album that we were trying to record, and the week of my quarantine was supposed to be all this stuff that we were supposed to be doing. And so I was in my quarantine quarters, and I remember sitting there, and I'm gonna be honest with you, Pastor Darnell felt defeated. I felt like I had let the team down, I had let the church down, I messed up, because there was so much that needed to be done and I couldn't do it. And I wanted this album to be so special and so right for the church to really capture our worshiping encounters here. And I was laying in bed one night, and I remember before I went to sleep, I was saying my prayers and I was like, God, I don't know what else to do. And if I can be real honest, in my 5 years here at Crossover, I felt like I've been in a writing slump. I used to be able to write and just write and boom. And I wasn't writing like I just, it just wasn't hitting. And I was like, God, I don't know what else to do. So I remember telling myself, like, internally, like, whatever you want to do, God, I'm done. And I woke up, it was like 2 o'clock in the morning, I woke up And I heard the Holy Spirit say, now. And I woke up, and immediately when I heard the Holy Spirit say, now, I said, have your way. And I got up out of my bed, and I went over to my little studio, and I just started to play. And I just said, have your way, Lord. And it was in that moment when I started saying that, that words started to come, that music started to happen, that melody started to come forth. And all I was saying was, Lord, have your way. Have your way.
Thank you. Jesus, I surrender.
Today, God, for being our refuge, our strength giver, our sustainer, our healer, our provider. Thank you for being so faithful to us. Thank you for being so faithful to us. Father, in this moment, I declare the Spirit of the living God will unleash a supernatural freedom in this house today. Even those that are worshiping online, I pray that they would experience the same fire of God in this place today. Our hearts and our minds are tuned in to you. Somebody needs hope today. Somebody needs faith today. Somebody needs strength today. Somebody needs clarity today. Somebody needs their joy back today. Holy Spirit, I don't say it as a cliche. From the bottom of my heart, I beg you today, Holy Spirit, have your way. Have your way. Do the heavy lifting. Cause yokes to be destroyed, burdens to be lifted and lighter. Healings and miracles and signs and wonders to show up in a real way today. I thank you that you'll be glorified in it all in Jesus' name. If you agree with that prayer, can you just join with me in a praise of celebration and anticipation? Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. I command my hands to praise the Lord. I command my voice to praise the Lord. I was glad when they said unto me, let's go to the house of the Lord. Why? Because God is going to meet us here. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Listen, if the President of the United States were to walk in, we would clap until they tell us to stop. But the King of Glory has walked in. Can you just clap your hands and celebrate the greatness of our God? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So glad to have all of you with us today. You've already been welcomed, but we're so thankful that you're here. And I just want to say, even before we begin the message, you are not here today on accident. God knew that you would be here even before the beginning of time. And so I just pray today you have ears to hear what God has to say to all of us today. Amen. You may have your seats today as we get ready to jump into the message. So good to see all of you all today.